How to tell if you're the only guy that she's seeing. Stay tuned.
I stay focused by blocking out the world. Too many complications with a modern day girl. I'd rather stack money taking trips around the world. Part introvert, expert, an expert at living skirts. I stay low key, but when I stunt, I can make it hurt. I go berserk, but then the girls, they want to call me jerks. They
get Welcome back to the Anthony Spade channel. Before we get started, I want you to watch the entire video. If you like the video, comment, like, subscribe at the end of the video. But first, watch the entire video. Next, I would not be talking about all women, even though it feels like it. And if you haven't subscribed to my second channel, Who is Anthony Spade, the link is in the description. All right, today I'm going to be talking about how to know if you're the only guy that she's talking to. Now, when it comes to you guys dating nowadays, one thing that you need to know is that typically when it comes to a woman, you're never the only guy that she's dating. A woman is always talking to multiple guys. The only way that you can literally get a woman to only focus on you is if she's confused as if you like her or not. She's confused as if you want to go to someone else. That's the only thing that gets a woman to stick around. Majority of these relationships that you see on surface, they're only acting on surface, and then behind the scenes, there's a whole nother story going on. But as you get older in life, a lot of you are going to notice the relationships that a woman is in love all the way, chances are her husband is not lovey-dovey with her. Now, you may find some couples that are 50 plus, 60 plus, that act like they're in love and they just love each other. You know what they love? They love the fact that they have someone to die with, or they have someone to be old with. So they try to act like they're in love, but they're just happy that they have somebody to go to church with. That's what it pretty much boils down to. But to everybody else out there, if you have a girlfriend right now, or you're talking to somebody right now, and you're just thinking about maybe taking that extra step, I want you to pay attention to these little things that I'm going to tell you today, so you can know if you're just a pawn in her world, or you're really the only guy that she's talking to. Let's get to it. First, she always picks up the phone. All right? That's what you need to know. She always picks up the phone every time you call. There's no such thing as I called her and then I got to wait 10 minutes for her to call back. It doesn't work like that. When a woman is dedicated to the relationship and she's dedicated to you, the reason why she's gonna always pick up the phone is because she's gonna always think she's needed for something. All right, you have to understand, if a woman wants to feel needed in the relationship, then she's looking long-term in the relationship. So if you call her, she's thinking, oh, this is just an emergency, or I haven't talked to him in a while and I want to hear his voice. All right, 9 times out of 10, if a woman's gonna talk to multiple guys, it's because she has one guy that's calling her all the time. If you call her all the time, at some point she's gonna stop picking up the phone. But if every time you call and she does pick up the phone, then that lets you know that you're not calling that often and you're still holding her interest. As long as you can hold a woman's interest, you'll be the only guy that she talks to the moment she starts getting bored, the moment she starts seeking mental stimulation. Next, this is a little one that a lot of you don't pay attention to, and this is an important one. She calls you by your name. All right, your name's John, she always calls you by John. Your name Tim, she always calls you by Jim. Tim, your name Anthony, she always calling you Anthony. She's always calling you by your first name, all right? And the reason why that's important is because when a woman is talking to multiple guys, she'll choose pet names like baby or babe or this. If you have a pet name with a woman, she talks to multiple guys because that's like a way of her not really happening to remember your name. So understand that when you see women calling their husbands and their boyfriends by the first name, that's the only guy that she's dealing with. If you have a pet name, Bay or something else, but she's never calling you her first name, it's mainly just baby or bae. If she's always using baby or bae, trust me, there is another guy. She just don't want to get you too conflicted whenever she's talking to you. Next, her phone never rings. Now, I know what you guys are thinking. If the phone never rings, it's easy to take the ringer off and then she can hide people calling her phone. It doesn't work like that. If a woman is talking to multiple people, she doesn't have any respect for you, which means that she don't want to miss out on any other part of the world. All right? So you're not really that important. What do I mean by that? What I mean by is, just because you and her are dating, she's not afraid to lose you whenever she's talking to multiple guys. So she'll let her phone ring. You'll hear all those messages come in, ding dings, the Instagrams. You'll constantly hear all that over and over again, and it'll aggravate you. But when you're the only one that she wants to deal with, you won't get a ring. You won't get any of that. She'll leave the phone off on purpose. Yeah, but it's not to hide other people. It's to keep from aggravating you. It's because she doesn't want to lose you because she wants to give you all of her attention. The only thing is, when you guys meet, you're already walking into a life where she has a lot of social media activity going on. And as she progresses in the relationship, it gets less and less and less. So understand, if you're around her and the phone's not ringing and she's not paying attention to it, then you're the only guy that she's dealing with. Next, she always wants to be around you. Now, this part makes you annoyed, all right? If she's annoying to you and you feel like she's smothering you, then there's a chance that that's the chance that you are the only guy that she's talking to. When a woman is talking to multiple guys, one thing that she does is she makes her lifestyle looks like it's busy doing her. She tries to make like she works a lot of hours, that she always has to go do this, and that she has a lot of activities going on with her life. If she's trying to make it sound like she's always busy and she doesn't have that much time for you, it's because it's another guy. Women are never that serious. Women are only working hard because a guy hasn't grabbed their attention yet. When a woman's attention is grabbed by a man, nothing else in the world matters to her. No other dude matters to her at all. So understand, if she's smothering you, then you're definitely the only guy that she's dealing with. Next, she's tagging you in social media, all right? She's sending tags with your name in it. Okay, now, two things that could be happening here. For one, you gotta see who else is in the tag. If you're the only one that's being tagged, then trust me, you're the only one that she's dealing with. But if you and a whole bunch of other people are being tagged, then you gotta kinda like back off that statement a little bit. But if you're the only one that's being tagged in social media, then she's definitely only dealing with you, or she's dedicating her attention to you. And the reason for that is, it's because she's probably not talking to you that much. You have to understand, women only stay interested in guys they barely talk to, guys that barely communicate with them. So chances are she's not talking to you on the phone that much. So she sends tags through social media as a way of communication. All right, it's a way of grabbing your attention, but you have to be careful that she's not trying to grab the attention of everybody. Next, this is a big one. You've met her friends and family, all right? Chances are, if you've met the friends and family, then you are the beta male provider. She only wants to be with you, but chances are she already have you locked in. You've already told her you love her. You've already started making plans for the future with her. You're not gonna meet the family until she's already started making plans in the future with you. So by the time you get around to meeting family and friends, yes, the relationship is going up a notch. Typically, when it comes to girls that are cheaters and girls that you're not gonna go the distance with, you typically only meet best friends and the girls that she go party with and their little boyfriends, and you never meet mom and dad and auntie and all them. You're always just meeting her new best friends is a sign that you're not the only guy that she's dealing with. But when she starts taking you around family and friends, then she's trying to make the relationship stronger, but you're not gonna get there until she's already made plans with you for the future. Next, last but not least, and this is a very, very, very big one. She's always affectionate when it's just you and her. It's a big difference. Being affectionate in public and being affectionate when it's just you and her alone, it's two different things. And the reason why I say that is because women are their natural self whenever they are alone and isolated. Which is why when you get married, you'll hear her fart, you'll see her get fat, you'll see all that stuff that you didn't see whenever she piled the makeup on. So understand, when it's you and her alone and she wants to be affectionate with you, then yes, you're the only guy. If when you and her alone and she's not affectionate, but when she gets out in public, all of a sudden she wants to be affectionate and all of a sudden she wants to act like y'all in love, then guess what? You're bait. She's using you as bait to make another man jealous. All right? If she's affectionate with you and it's just you and her, but then when y'all in public, it's a regular relationship, yes, you're the only one. Trust me. Everything that a woman does on surface is always done to deliver a message to others, especially when it comes to love and relationships. Holding hands, walking down the street, and showing another girl, look, I got a man, I'm not lonely. Hugging you and kissing you in front of people is trying to make another man jealous. So keep in mind, if she does all these things and it's just you and her, you're the only one. All right? Hopefully you guys are able to pay attention to these clues that I gave today, and hopefully it gets you closer to being more confident and understanding women. This is Anthony Spade. Comment, like, subscribe to both of my channels. Hasta la vista.